在印度南部泰米尔纳德，信奉印度教的渔民在亲人死了之后三个月焚烧祭品，然后将灰烬三个月前，在印尼发生的九级地震，引发南亚、东非一共十一个国家受到海啸袭击。海啸由印尼外海开始，直到印度东南沿岸二千几公里的地区。在印度南部一条渔村，这一片黄土之下，当地人说埋葬了八千几个海啸遇难者。海啸对南亚地区带来的财物损失固然难以估计，但是失去亲人的伤痛，金钱绝对无法弥补。
关心一个灾区一段短时间容易的，好像香港咁样有七亿嘅善款，我就睇到香港居民好热心。但系咧，货一个长期，可能咧两年啊、三年啊，甚至五年嘅社区同心灵重建咧，我相信呢一个咧就系需要我哋学习嚟到去关心呢一啲咧贫穷嘅地方嘅一个心态。
你冇忘记呢个地方，你私恩喺呢度啦。有好多居民咧系贫穷。
海啸后三个星期。几个香港牧师来到印度灾区，了解灾民的需要。
Many people they told night time I'm not getting sleep and nightmares come. I think about my worries and I dream about the thing that comes to my mind.
I'm asking God daily, even today whole night I asked God. God, I want to know the purpose of. It's serious.Why you have taken my children? I want to know the truth.
海啸至今，印度官方公布死亡人数超过一万，失踪人口五千几。但系民间相信，死亡同失踪嘅人数远远超过呢啲数字。李建华牧师一行五人，海啸之前本来打算为印度儿童募集教育经费。天灾之后，他们还计划为失去父母的细路起孤儿院，
屋不知几时建，小蚊仔没有书读，不知几时有书读，同埋咧就冇父母冇孤儿，仍旧咧喺自己啊嗰啲嘅亲戚屋企，我就感受到咧，即系喺佢嘅心灵嘅里边咧嗰种唔知明天嗰种嘅感觉。
海啸发生当日系工程师 Carrie Biren 嘅生日。他点都没想过，这一天他和太太永远失去三个挚爱的仔女和七个亲人。
We don't get the sleep also. It's about 20 days, I can say, the sleepless nights. In the night time, I'm coming down and searching my children's. At least somewhere my children's voice want to hear their voice. Somewhere else.
海啸发生之后十日，印度曾经向外界表示有足够的能力应付灾情，拒绝国际社会即时的援助。
What we have stated is that as of now, we feel that we have enough resources and capabilities at hand to be able to deal with this disaster.
而一直在印度做开救援工作的国际组织 无国界医生在灾难发生之后即时去到灾区训练当地的村民成为心理辅导员，为灾民提供为期至少六个月的紧急服务。
We have spoken to some people where the entire family was wiped out. So the grieving is extremely intense and the stress, the fear of going back to the ocean. The fishermen shared that with us, the children talked about their fear and the women talked about their fear, even the fear of resettling back into their old place. Just do it very gently.
心理治疗师 Adrian 认为灾难创伤的心理辅导最好由本地人自己去做。
In some village, people are like sitting and they are looking blankly at the seashore, and there are some people are looking at the sky. They don't know what is going to happen in the near future. I was able to observe that people are playing cards near the seashore, so that any waves come, these people can go and alert the people those who are sleeping.
离开印度本土千几公里以外有500几个岛聚，由于接近震央受到海啸严重破坏，印度官方指出岛上死亡和失踪的人口超过7000。一月中，铿锵集记者来到其中最大的安达曼岛，居民说水位比海啸前高了3尺，沿海很多条村每日潮涨都会水浸，而且发生过百几次5级以上的余震，他们有时都不敢在屋里面睡觉。印度政府将部分灾情严重的外岛居民安置在安达曼岛的广场和学校。一月中，官方透露单在这里的12个营地总共住了4300几个灾民。
好，整个浸晒，啲水由四方八面涌入嚟，涌埋岸边，成两公里噶。而家我哋个岛变得咁细咋？
呢个难民营嘅灾民嚟自偏远嘅尼科巴群岛，天灾过后，佢哋被迫离开家园，等待救援。
我哋住喺度，收到啲食物同衣服，就系呢啲。每个家庭政府都俾咗2000卢比救济金。
印度政府拒绝接受国际社会紧急协助。海啸之后，本地志愿组织纷纷由其他省市赶到。呢一班由孟买嚟嘅义工，带住医生同埋药物，漏夜赶住搭10个钟头嘅船，去一个少人关注嘅重灾区小安达曼岛。船上逼满海啸后第一次翻屋企的灾民，同埋一心谂住去救灾的本地团体。
The government is not sure whether they're going to build the house and what kind of houses they're going to build. They literally don't have money. They lost everything. That's one area.Which we need a very lot of help. I think mainly our government has refused outside help. Basically, that's the thing where outside help is not coming much here now. Probably we need outside help in order to get the project like this. 471 houses for them. This village after village to resettle, we need somebody's help. International monetary.
其实咧，人好善忘嘅啫，特别对于咧一啲唔开心嘅嘢咧，好快就忘记。我觉得我哋都要不断咁样去学习，你对即系同苦难嘅人咧，能够同行一段嘅时间。
海啸几分钟之间就摧毁人嘅一生心血，灾难过后， 受影响的人几时至复原，能够重过正常生活呢？印度受到海啸袭击，至今已经整整3个月。受灾严重的小安达曼岛居民逐渐投入正常的生活。天灾过后，很多灾民仍然无家可归，住在帐篷。他们觉得岛上天气出现变化，居住环境变得越来越差。
This salt water, all the trees are destroyed and the heat becomes, so temperature direct attacked us. Due to this, we are feeling hot and this tent in the hot day climate, no people stay here, no, at daytime. Due to tsunami, all the salt water coming here and all the wells water become salty.
世界卫生组织资料显示，印度还有40000个住在岛聚的灾民，分布在100多个不同的营地，等紧搬入政府起的临时房屋。在远离海边的山林，工人赶紧在下个月雨季之前起好临时房屋，俾灾民入住。岛上连贯南北的主要公路被海啸冲断，根本冇办法行车。本来只要30分钟的车程，我哋摄制组的吉普车最后唯有穿过山林，用了足足2个钟头，先至去到19公里外一个营地。呢度住咗900个灾民，佢哋话到目前为止，政府仍然未有计划安置佢哋。
Due to the tsunami and earthquake effect, the electricity is not supplying properly, as because the line which is damaged from 6 p.m. to 9 or 10 p.m. electricity provided us only 3 hours.40 to 45 tents at present we are having here. The latrines are not available. They are going to the jungles. Even the young ladies' cooking place are not available. It is not possible to running their livelihoods as normal ways. And they needed this all kinds of help in short time.
营地的主管投诉3个月来，政府一直没有修筑好条主要公路，影响物资的运输。现在2、3个家庭要逼埋住在一个帐篷。
Very few NGOs are coming here. They returned back after their service. With the bad transportation is the main problem for them.
Today we have to face a very big hurdles to by walking with carrying our luggage and medicines.
呢队医疗队由加尔各答长途跋涉嚟到1000多公里外嘅小岛，一心谂住帮岛上灾民，但嚟到之后发觉寸步难行，政府承诺嘅协助完全冇兑现，佢哋觉得好失望。
For this place of Little Andaman, government should give the proper logistic help so that our activities and our service should be in a properly utilized for the benefit of the tsunami victims. But it is not properly done.
医疗队的医生指出，灾民住在帐幕3个月， 健康已经响起警号，加上岛上医疗服务不足，雨季即将来临，如果政府唔及早处理，后果不堪设想。
They are suffering from respiratory disease, some sort of skin disease. They are staying within a very short space, and at the same time, the many complaining of gastrointestinal disease like diarrhea disease, communicating to others, one children to other children, one person to other. It's our demand that within a very short period.The arrangement, permanent arrangement should be done for their physical and at the same time for their mental, rehabilitation.
Earthquake 摧毁咗印度超过150,000民居。而家东南部沿海灾区，大部分灾民已经搬入临时房屋，而政府向每户受灾家庭发放4000卢比。大约$100，每个月另有补助，但是灾民大部分是渔民，他们说最希望政府能够帮他们买新船，等他们可以再次出海。
The village people that demand 80 boat, 80 engine, something net that is.
村入面呢几艘新船由外国团体捐赠。呢一日，一班加拿大人专程嚟到。打算透过当地志愿组织，将渔船、摩打等等谋生工具捐俾村民，等佢哋可以自力更生。海啸发生后，无国界医生即时训练本地义工做心理辅导员。
夜晚瞓觉嗰阵，我听到海浪声，好惊啊！
咁你会点做？
我叫阿嫲去海边睇下。
你叫声你阿嫲去海边嗰度睇啊？
阿嫲都仲未瞓。
你觉得点样？
我会成身震啊！
你瞓着咗都成身震啊？
嗯。
点解你咁惊咧？
我谂翻起海啸嚟嗰阵，我系咁走。
当地心理学家 Rajan 每日都会落村同辅导员一起跟进个案，他发觉有村民开始用饮酒来麻醉自己。
And it's been common in males. The way they try to relieve that. Many people they told night time I'm not getting sleep and nightmares come. I think about my worries and I dream about the thing that comes to my mind. To overcome this, I take alcohol. They feel somewhat relieved.And particularly men who are injured in the sea, you know, they are unable to bear the pain of that one.
我好难过啊！我好锡我两个女啊，好痛苦啊，真系好难过。如果我哋唔系仲有一个仔嘅，我谂我会自杀。每一日都好难过，我成日都喊。当我见到佢哋嘅手额啊、衫裙啊。佢哋嘅相啊，我都谂翻起佢哋啊。
Particularly, we have seen three people have suicided after tsunami. One guy is hanged by himself. Another man is 60 years plus. He got the money from bank to buy a boat, and it was washed out. And was unable to bear it, committed suicide.
虽然有灾民受唔住打击，选择结束生命，但系 Rajan 认为。村民遭逢巨变，好需要依靠紧密嘅关系，帮自己重新建立正常生活。最近呢个几月，特别多村民结婚。
So far, I think more than 100 marriages would have gone. And really, quite a difficult aspect we saw is that 42-year-old man, he has 5 female kids, and he is married his wife's sister. People like a 16-year and 18-year male getting married, and it's quite. I don't know how the future will, how they will be able to take care. Already they have lost all the things. They think somewhat they'll get support from the government, and the newly constructed house will be given to them if they are married.
面对大自然，人类变得好渺小。在海啸中痛失三个仔女的工程师 Carrie Buren 并没有放弃，他特别关心失去亲人的小朋友，还资助他们留在自己的村继续生活。
We are the comforter for them, we'll be encouraging them, we'll be supporting, we'll do our service best to the bring out of the people who are in the dark.
April 14th 是泰米尔新年，祝愿印度灾民尽快重建新生活。
So waiting, yeah.Cannot doubt the problem that is. So, now mind, you're fixing the date, April 15th. Okay, start the working.